Fractured group MI reporting is a consistent problem across Continuum clients. In the user case above, we describe how a fund administrator's business grew rapidly by acquiring other small organizations, and how that issue of fractured group-wide MI reporting was overcome by using the Alteryx server. This client has teams and organizations across multiple jurisdictions, including some in Luxembourg, which can openly share network infrastructure with other areas of the business. They do, however, have a successful Warescape Red data warehouse deployment, but many hours continue to be wasted debugging data errors introduced by other parts of the business who don't have different systems in different locations with data structured differently in each. This mostly manual process introduced numerous errors, required repeated resubmissions of the data, and therefore just led to a lack of confidence in the reported figures by decision makers. A traditional approach would be to enforce something along the lines of a common reporting template. However, the disparity between the organizations simply led to additional errors, with each organization requiring to report on different metrics. Continuum instead delivered an Alteryx server-based solution that allowed for centralized reporting whilst keeping the data format and quality the responsibility of that submitting organization. Now, if we take a look at the image we have up on screen at the moment, firstly, the Alteryx designer users themselves around the business would build individual apps for each one of the business users or departments or organizations. That app is then deployed to this Alteryx gallery level. Then you'll see we have the business users down here at the bottom. Each one of these business users will have permissions to access only the application that's been developed for them. That application has been tailored uniquely to interpret that data format, so there's no need for the user to go ahead and manually change the format in which they receive their data. Just simply log on to the Alteryx gallery, upload their data, and it was then submitted or validated against the conformed rules we have in place. If the data should be rejected or doesn't conform to the expected formats, a list of errors is returned to the user, and it's therefore their responsibility to review these errors, make the required changes in their formats, i.e. make sure we have all the required columns, making sure we have values in all the required fields. However, should the data be successfully submitted and pass all of those validation tests, it's then passed up the chain here into the group data warehouse. Now, once all the business users have reported their metrics across the reporting period, then at the end of that period, group MI reporting can then be reported from the group data warehouse at the top level here, confidently, with no manual effort required at all. So now let's see the solution in action. What you're seeing here on the screen at the moment is the Alteryx gallery sign-in window. So this is the view that the end business user will have when they're going ahead to upload that data to the Alteryx gallery. I'll go ahead and sign in. What you're going to be presented with is that each user will have this private studio. This private studio only shows them the applications, workflows, or macros that they've been provisioned access to see. So therefore, only the user will see the workflows that are relevant to them and not everything else. I'll go ahead and click on this template validation workflow that I've got here and click on to run. What you're then going to see is there's a small interface here that's presented to the user, just listing a few different questions which they'll need to fill out before their data is submitted. First and foremost, I can go ahead and browse to that file I want to go upload. Of course, it's not restricted to simply one file. I could have multiple here I may want to upload in a single instance. And as I described earlier on, there's a couple of different validation tests that are happening here to the data. First one I'm going to demonstrate is something called template validation. So there's some checks in this particular example that just make sure that we have all the required fields for this particular data input. If we're missing a mandatory field, such as an ID or an amount, then what we're going to do is we're going to push back an error to the user at runtime just to say, make sure you got these fields in and go ahead and resubmit. So let's go ahead and take a look at what something like that would look like. Clicking on open, select the required sheet that I'd like. And I've got a few various different questions here. So you may want to present some questions to users, such as the date they submit, maybe list the department which they're a part of. This interface, as I say, is completely customizable by designer users themselves. So once I've selected and filled out the questions, simply click on run. And in this particular example, we've got a couple of template errors here. First is we're missing a row total funds. So maybe we're missing a totals row there. And also missing a few key columns in this submission, such as the jurisdiction and the termination date. So what's this simply saying is just please ensure that these fields are present in your data set and go ahead and resubmit. So this data actually hasn't been passed up to that data warehouse level. It's therefore been pushed back to the end user. It's their responsibility to make sure that their data is in good shape to make before it goes ahead and gets submitted. Now, if I go ahead and run this once again, I'm going to go ahead and select a different file for this run. I'm going to set one called validation. Now, the validation relates to some errors which I call data validation. So we may have all of the required fields, i.e. we have got the ID field, we have got the amounts field, but there's some discrepancies within those fields which would constitute some things called data validation errors, i.e. we're missing an ID. We have the ID field, but we don't have a value in one of these ID records. So what I'm going to do is click on run again, and rather than present an error message to the user on this screen here, what we've got is this downloadable data validation report in an Excel format. Again, this format can be customized by you. We can push this to a SQL database, possibly even a SharePoint list. Again, it is completely customizable within the Alteryx Designer. Once that's been downloaded, as the user, I can pop this open and say, hey, what's wrong with my data input here? And I can pop along and see this entity name here, i.e. AC Institute, is missing all of these missing values in all of these fields. So therefore, I have to go make sure and I fill in the required data in these fields for this particular entity before my submission will be accepted. Now, if I close it down, and let's go to example where I've actually taken note of these template and data validation errors, and I've cleaned up my data set, and I'm ready to go ahead and resubmit. So I click on Browse, and I'm going to put in my clean example now, just to show you what it would look like if a user would successfully submit their data. So again, you fill out the question form here, click on Run, and success. Successful template validation. Submission was successful, no validation errors were found. Now the user can be confident that data has been passed up to the data warehouse level and that group-wide MR reporting can happen at the end of the reporting period with no manual requirements at all. Continuum's role evolved in this example by firstly building the workflows that you see working here in action on the Alteryx gallery to providing productionization, and now simply QA support to position where the client is solely self-sufficient.